Hello, I'm Aida Lakhmij, a PhD student from Sousse University Tunisia. I'm glad to join you today to present our work entitled Dynamic Reconfiguration of Cloud Composite Services Using Event View. Our presentation outline contains an introduction, related work, our motivations, the Event View method, our Event View formal model, our verification and validation approach, and finally, we conclude and give insights into our future works. We start by the introduction. Cloud environment is a high dynamic environment. Constantly, new services are added and others are deleted due to unavailability, faulty behavior, or performance degradation. A faulty component service must be dynamically replaced in order to preserve the functional and non-functional correctness of the composite service. This work presents a formal approach to verify the dynamic behavior of the cloud composite service. We focus on the correctional dynamics such as the substitution of faulty or unavailable services and resources. The proposed event-based approach ensures the preservation of the composite service consistency, reliability, and efficiency after the substitution of faulty or unavailable components. We move now to a related work in ABID 2016. Author deals partly with the dynamic reconfiguration of cloud applications. They use the unifying theory of programming to provide a formal model to understand and reason about cloud services. However, they do not assess the semantic and behavior properties during reconfiguration, which may affect the correctness of the application. In the work presented by Meng, entitled A Formal Design Model for Cloud Services, a novel protocol to reconfigure cloud applications that supports virtual machines failure is presented. The reconfiguration always terminates successfully, even in the presence of a finite number of failures. In 2015, we have proposed a work entitled Formal Modeling for Verifying SCI Dynamic Composition with Event B, where we have presented an Event B-based approach to deal with the component service reconfiguration in the service component architecture context. It checks the structural and behavioral compatibility between the replacing service and the faulty service. The proposed work lacks the semantic verification of the replacement. The present work is an extension of our recent work published in the Formal Aspect of Computing journal entitled An Event-Based Approach for Cloud Composite Service Verification, where we have verified the structural, semantic, and behavioral correctness of the composite service. We have also checked the allocation of cloud resources to the component service. We move now to our motivations. Our motivating example is the travel booking composite service, which is constituted of six component services: the web form request service, the search flight, search hotel, booking, credit card payment, and reservation confirmation service. These component services require cloud resources in order to execute. The web form requests require network resources. The search flight, search hotels requires both storage and compute resource. The booking component service requires a storage resource. The credit card payment component service requires a compute resource. And the reservation confirmation component service requires a network resource. Now, what to do when a component service is no longer available, or when it behaves in a faulty way? For example, if the FS, search flight component service, fails, we have to find a new component service denoted here by NFS, which is able to search for a flight. The first requirement here is to check the semantic compatibility between the new service and the old service in terms of input, outputs, precondition, and effects. For instance, in terms of inputs, the new component service must have the same type of inputs as old S in order to be compatible with the output of the web form request component service. The second requirement is to the verification of the behavioral compatibility between both component services in order to preserve the behavior correctness of the composite service and avoid the blocking situation. Here, for each message that will be sent or received by the replacement component service, there must be a component service that will respectively receive or send that message. It is important to manage the resource allocated to the new component service in order to avoid any deadlock situation related to the resource shareability properties. Resources can also break down and become unavailable, which affects the composite service execution. The replacing resource must be able to handle the component services running on the old resource in terms of capacity and shareability properties. In this context, formal methods prevail to capture the semantic and behavior of complex and critical systems. They use mathematical models for the analysis of computing communication and industrial systems in order to establish system correctness with mathematical rigor, which makes them highly recommended verification technique in this field. In this work, we use the event-V method to verify the cloud composite service correctness. The event-V method is developed by John Raymond Abrial. It is used in major safety critical system applications in Europe, such as the Paris Metro Line 14. It uses mathematical notations to specify and model software systems in a mathematically sound way. It enables incremental development of software step by step from abstract level to more detailed levels and possibly to code level, thanks to its refinement feature, which enables to master the complexity of systems. A stepwise refinement approach produces a correct by-construction specification, since we prove the different properties of the system at each step. The event-B specification is made of two elements, a context and a machine. A context describes the static part of an event-B specification. It contains the closed sets that describe the set of abstract and enumerated types. The closed constants represent the constants of the model. The closed axioms contains all the properties of the constants and their types. The event-B machine describes the dynamic part of an event-B specification. It is composed of the closed variables that represent the state variables of the model, the closed invariant that define the invariant properties of the system, and the closed event containing the list of events related to the model. An event is modeled with a guarded substitution and fired when its guards are evaluated to true. When the guards are evaluated to true, the event actions are executed. The event occurring in an event-B model affects the state described in the closed variables. We move now to the presentation of our formal model. We start by our model architecture that contains four levels. The first level is constituted by the structure machine and models the structural properties of the cloud composite service. The semantic machine models the semantic properties of the cloud composite service. The behavior machine models the behavior properties, and the resource machine adds details about the resource allocation. We move now to the modeling of the service substitution. We have in the structure level, we have defined the substitute CS event that has five parameters. C, the composite service containing a faulty or unavailable service, component service, old as the faulty or unavailable component service, new as the replacing component service we are searching for. OP1 and OP2 are respectively the operations of the old service and the new service. The state of old S in the guard 3, we require that the state of old S is failed. In the guard 4, the state of new S is deployed. The first requirement is here is that the replacing component service must be functionally compatible with the faulty service in order to accomplish the desired task. Therefore, in the guard 5, we require that the new service provides the same function of operation as old S. The non-functional selection is also performed at this level to maintain the quality of service of the composite service. In the guard of availability and reliability, we require that the availability and reliability of the new component service are greater or equal to the availability and reliability values offered by the previous service. In the guards of cost and response time, we require that the cost of and the response time of the new service are lower or equal to the cost and response time offered by the old component service. After the execution of this event, in action 1, the old service is deleted from the set of component service constituting the composite service C and is replaced by new S. The state of new S in action 2 is set to ready to invoke in order to enable the execution of this component service. In the semantic level, we define the substitute CS event to check the semantic compatibility between the old S and the new S. The new service must preserve the composition consistency in terms of vertical and horizontal matching. This is translated in event B in the guards 6 and 7. The new service must have the same inputs as the old S in order to execute and must produce the same outputs as old S. New S and old S must also be compatible in terms of precondition and effects, which is traduced by the guards 9 and 10, 8 and 9. We move now to the behavior abstraction level, where we define the substitute CS event in order to check the interacting protocols. Therefore, we assume that for each message that will be sent received, there is a component service that will respectively receive send that message. The protocol of old S and the protocol of new S must have the same number, type, and order of message. This is expressed in event B through the guards 10 and 11. Cloud resources are managed in the resource level. The set of resources allocated to old S are released. After its selection, the allocate resource event will be triggered to allocate resources to the new S component service. We move now to the modeling of the resource substitution. A resource allocated to the component service can also break down or become unavailable. In this situation, if this situation happens, during component service execution, it will affect the composite service execution and lead to failure. Therefore, we have added a new event called substitute air in order to substitute failed or unavailable resources. To substitute a resource, the replacing resource should have the same capacity or more, the same type, the same shareability properties, or less restricted one. This is expressed in event B in regards of the substitute L event. In regard 3, we require that the new resource have the same type as the old resource. In regard 4, we require that the available capacity of the new resource is greater than or equal to the global capacity of the old resource. In regard 6, 7, and 8, we require that the new resource has the same properties as the old resource, respectively in terms of shareability, elasticity, and scalability. A non-functional selection is performed in regards 10, 11, 12, and 13. In regards 10 and 11, we require that the new resource availability and reliability values are greater or equal to the availability and reliability values offered by the old resource. In the regards 12 and 13, we require that the cost and response time values of the new resource are lower or equal to the cost and response time of the old resource. After the event execution, the action 1 and 2 are performed to respectively. In action 1, the new resource is allocated to the set of services that old air were allocated to. In action 2, the set of services running on old air are moved to the new resource. We move now to the model verification and validation. A verification and validation approach combining both proof obligations and model checking is performed. A proof obligation is a theorem that needs to be proved in order to verify the correctness of the model. Proof obligations ensure that each event preserves the environs. We have also used the probe animator. It is an animator and constraint solver and model checker for the event B method. It allows fully automatic animation of B specification and can be used to systematically check a specification for a wide range of errors. The constraint solving capabilities of ProBe can also be used for model finding, deadlock checking, and test case generation. Now we conclude and give insights into our future works. In this work, we have addressed the cloud composite service dynamic reconfiguration problem. We have presented several constraints that must be considered while replacing a faulty or unavailable component service or resource by a new one. The verification is done on four abstraction levels: the structural, semantic, behavioral, and resource allocation levels. A proof-based approach coupled with model animation is performed in order to verify and validate the proposed model. In the near future, we aim to extend the present work by considering other kinds of dynamics such as adaptive dynamic and/or evolutionary dynamic. We are also planning to develop an Eclipse plugin to automate the present approach in order to be readily used in practice. Thank you for your attention. For any questions, you can find me at aida.lakmish@gmail.com.